In this video, we're going to talk about variables, and variables are a critical thing in programming, and so it's really important that you understand these concepts. I'm going to go ahead and create a new Java class, and I'm going to call it public class variable fun. Opening curly brace, come down a few lines, closing curly brace, public static void main string, opening closing bracket args. Opening curly brace, come down a few lines, closing curly brace, and then indent, and I'm ready to go now. What I'm going to do in this program is just print out an age. And as I think about something like age, for whatever reason, I don't know why this is, I love that being 25 years old. It was my favorite age. Any of you 25 out there? I don't know exactly what it was about it, but it was a lot of fun. And I suppose at every age there's good parts, right? I look at my 4-year-old son, and he doesn't have a whole lot of care in the world. He plays and has fun and leads a pretty easygoing life, which for a guy like me that works all the time, that seems pretty appealing, right? He, on the other hand, probably looks at me and says, "Well, you know, Dad gets to do whatever he wants, and he gets to, you know, eat candy whenever he wants, and he can buy whatever he wants." Little does he know. But anyway, the point is there's probably good things about all ages, but I'm just going to go ahead and print out the age of 25 for a minute. So I'm going to say, I am 25 years old. Okay, so that's the age. I'm going to go ahead and save this. And it wants me to save over variable fun. That's a little hint to you that this is not take one, if you only knew. I'm going to go ahead and save that and then compile it and then run it again. And so it prints out that what I told it to print out, I am 25 years old. The problem is if we put something like this into a program, it is always going to print out the number 25 in this sentence, I am 25 years old. And the problem with something like age is it changes from year to year, right? We get a year older every year, and so this age is going to rotate. And so this age is not a constant. This age is a variable that's going to continually change. And so we don't want to do this in our programs. This is what we call hard coding a number into the program. And so in this example, we want age to change based on something. And so in this case, maybe it's years since the individual was born. And so rather than printing out something like this, I'm going to change this for just 1 minute and only print out the number. Now again, I don't want to, when I put this in quotes, it's always going to print out 25. Every time I run this program, it's going to print out the age of 25. The problem is I have a birthday the year after that, and I turn 26, right? So what I want to do instead is put this number inside a variable. Now, a variable is a place in memory that we're creating that we're going to reserve to store information for us. And there's lots of different types of variables that we'll talk about in just a minute. But for now, I am going to create an integer variable because 25 is an integer, right? So I'm going to create an integer variable, and we do that by saying int, and that turns purple because that's a reserved word in Java. Int means I want to declare an integer, and I'm going to call it age. Okay? That's the name I'm giving to it, and we'll talk more about that in a second too. And I am going to set that age equal to 25. Okay? So, recapping here, I went out and declared an integer, which is just a space in memory to hold some information, and I'm going to refer to that address in memory as age. And then I say, go out to age and put a 25 in there, and now that's what's going to be stored in age. Okay, so if we look at it in a, I wasn't planning on doing this, but I'll do it. If we look at it from a kind of visual perspective, I've got memory, you know, when you go down to the store and buy a stick of memory for your computer, and it's made up of a bunch of bits in the computer. And so if you buy a 4 gigabytes of memory, that's 4 billion bytes, and there's 8 bytes to a bit, so that's 32 billion bits. And what I'm saying is go take some of those bits. So there's all these bits in the computer. I'm saying go out and grab a chunk of bits and reserve them to store the age. I really need to get a pen board. Okay, age. That says age. And that now is a location in memory to hold variables, to hold information that's going to change. And then I say, so that's this part. In fact, I can just do that, and that will do this. It'll go out to memory, reserve a place in memory to store some information. And then I say, after you've done that, go set it equal to 25. And what happens is it goes out to that slot in memory and puts a 25 out there. And now that's sitting out in memory waiting to be used. Well, now I can come back in and to my program, and instead of printing out the literal age 25, I can instead print out age. Now, I don't put this in quotations. If I put this in quotations, it's going to literally print out the word age, but I don't want it to print out the word age. I want it to interpret the word age as a variable sitting out in memory, right? And so I run this again, and notice what happened. Instead of printing out the word age, it instead went out to the memory location that age refers to in memory and looked to see what was sitting out there, and what was sitting out there was a 25. And so what it prints out is a 25. Okay, does that make sense? And so we use these variables all the time in programming to store information temporarily until we can do something with it. We go out and say, reserve me a spot in memory, a certain length long, and we'll talk about that. And I'm going to use that to store information. It's kind of like right now we're my wife and I are looking at moving, not looking at, we are moving. and we need to, there's going to be a time where we have sold our old house before we move into our new house where we're going to need to store some stuff. And so we're going to get a storage shed and take all of our couches and shelves and boxes and put them into the storage shed temporarily until it's time to use them at the new house. And that's the concept of a variable. We're going to take and store information in the variable so that we can then access it later. All right, so we'll continue on with the variable discussion in the next video. Spencer out.